In a trapezium ABCD, if AB is parallel to CD, then AC squared plus BD squared is equal to dash. Anybody got this in the examination? Anybody solved it in the exam correctly? So you have a trapezium AB CD. How will you approach this question? See, they have given us a trapezium ABCD. Okay, and here it is given AB is parallel to CD. You have to find out the value of AC squared. That is, you have to find out what is AC squared plus BD squared, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop two perpendiculars from A and B. So I name this as F and E. Okay, now let us consider the, again here the proof is a bit, the way that you arrive at the answer is a bit lengthy. That is, there are some steps involved. Anyway, we'll try it out. So here what is given, see, this is a perpendicular that I am dropping. So this is a right angle, remember. So if I consider this triangle ADF, what do I get? See, if I consider the triangle ADF, I can say that AD squared, right? This AD squared is equal to AF squared plus FD squared. So AD squared, that is equal to AF squared plus FD squared. See, I considered the triangle ADF, the right angle triangle ADF. Now, if I consider the triangle AFC, what can I say? I can say AC squared, that is equal to, see, basically I have to find out what is AC squared plus BD squared. So with the right angle triangles that I am having, I am trying to arrive at the answer. So here I can say this AC squared is equal to AF squared plus FC squared. AC squared is equal to AF squared plus FC squared. So from this first statement, what can I say? I can say AF squared is equal to AD squared minus FD squared, right? See, from this first statement that I got, first I considered triangle ADF, then I considered triangle AFC, okay? So when I considered triangle ADF, I got this basic Pythagoras theorem. Again, when I considered triangle AFC, I got this. Or I can say here AF squared is equal to AD squared minus FD squared. I am substituting that here in this equation. So what do I get? This will become FC squared plus AD squared minus FD squared. So this is one equation that I have. Let us keep this equation there. Now, similarly, consider the other triangle. See, what is BD squared? If you consider the triangle BDE. Yes, if I consider the triangle BDE, again using Pythagoras theorem, what can I say? I can say BD squared is equal to DE squared plus BE squared. Similarly, if I consider triangle BEC, again a right angle triangle, what can I say? I can say BC squared is equal to BE squared plus EC squared. Or from this one, I can say BE squared, that is equal to BC squared minus EC squared. Or how will this equation be written as? This is, now I can say BD squared, that is equal to DE squared plus BC squared minus EC squared. So these are the two equations that I have now. Now, what do you do? What should I find out? I have to find out the value of AC squared plus BD squared. Add these two equations, what will you get? AC squared plus BD squared, that is equal to, add these two, right? FC squared plus AD squared minus FD squared plus DE squared plus BC squared minus EC squared, right? So here at this point, this AD and BC, you can take it to one side. You have AD squared plus BC squared. And then what other terms do I have? I have FC squared, FD squared, DE squared, EC squared. So what do I do with all of this? So here plus FC squared minus FD squared plus DE squared minus EC squared. Again, I have, if you look at FC, what is FC? FC is nothing but FE plus EC, right? So FC is nothing but FE plus EC. See, in the examination, you cannot do all this unless you remember this as a formula, that AC squared plus BD squared is whatever the answer is. I am just solving it so that we have, you know, how to arrive at the answer. But unless you remember this as a theorem or you by heart it, you will not be able to do these steps in the examination. I am just explaining since it is just a session. Okay, so here what will you have? So this, wherever you have DE, right, this DE you can write it as DF plus FE. Similarly, wherever you have FC, right, if you have FC, you can write it as FE plus EC. So when you write this, what will you get? So if I put it that way, I'll get AD squared plus BC squared. This will be FE plus EC the whole squared, or that is nothing but you can expand it as FE squared plus EC squared plus 2FE into EC, right, minus FD squared. Again, here you will have, this is DF plus FE the whole squared, right, which is nothing but DF squared plus FE squared plus 2DF FE minus EC squared. Now here a lot of your terms will get cancelled, right? So you have plus EC squared minus EC squared. Then here you have FE squared, one more FE squared is there, no? Here, another FE squared. So what will this become? This will be AD squared plus BC squared plus 2FE squared plus 2 into DF into FE plus FE into EC, right? Which is again nothing but, this is nothing but here you have FE as common in both the places. So you will have DF plus EC. What is DF? You have DF, EC, FE, right? So if I take this FE as common from all the terms, I will have AD squared plus BC squared plus 2EF into EF plus DF plus EC, right? All this add together to DC, right? So again, I have the answer that I get here at this point is AD squared plus BC squared plus 2EF into DC. Now what is EF? See, EF is nothing but AB. So this becomes AB. So sorry, the way I have written. Yeah, so this is the final answer that you get. That will be option A, right? So either you remember this as a property in a trapezium, if you have AB parallel to CD, then you can say AC squared plus BD squared is equal to this. Now again, it is sometimes it is very difficult for us to remember such minor formulas, right? Generally, you know, this is not some property that you always that tends to come in the examination. Very rarely do we get such questions. If you can remember, well and good, but otherwise it is better to skip. See, what I did here was I took this FE squared, FE common. So when I take FE common, right, see, I have FE squared here, one FE here and one FE here. So if I take an FE common, inside I have EF plus DF plus EC. So EF plus DF plus EC is nothing but DC. So this whole thing I am substituting it as DC. Then again, I know AB is equal to EF. I put that, I'll get AD squared plus BC squared plus 2ABDC. Again, as I said, too many equations sometimes we might forget in the examination. So let's hope that if the same question comes, I'm sure all of you will answer it correctly. Okay, because now you have seen this equation and you have seen the lengthy calculation that I did to arrive at the answer.